Good morning, children. We are continuing the chapter body fluids and its circulation. In this module, we will be studying about double circulation. Double circulation. Let me explain how double circulation happens in mammals or in human beings. We know that the ventricles, right and left ventricles, contract. The blood is pumped out from the heart. Okay, that is the first point. Now, from the right ventricle, the blood is pumped through the pulmonary artery, which is only artery in the body that carries the deoxygenated blood. Okay, so pulmonary artery carries the deoxygenated blood to the lungs. So the blue color represents the deoxygenated blood and this part of the lungs. Okay, and in the lungs, the carbon dioxide is removed, diffused out from the blood, and oxygen is diffused into the blood. So the blood is oxygenated now, with red color. You can understand that. So the oxygenated blood will come to the left atrium. Starting from the right ventricle, the blood will come back to the left atrium. Such a circulation is called pulmonary circulation. Pulmonary means related to the lungs, the word meaning lungs. So what is pulmonary circulation? When the ventricles pump the blood from the right ventricle, the blood is pumped through the pulmonary artery to the lungs, where the carbon dioxide is removed and the oxygen is mixed with the blood. That the oxygen which blood will come to the left atrium through pulmonary vein. So this is called pulmonary circulation. Okay, now what is the next? Systemic circulation. There is another word that we call systemic circulation. S-Y-S-T-E-M-I-C, systemic. The word is written here, systemic circulation. So what is systemic circulation? From different body parts, the blood from various body parts, all body parts, head to the limb, okay, head to the limbs. The blood from all the body parts, which is deoxygenated, okay, the blood coming from the body parts are deoxygenated, means carbon dioxide rich blood. Here is oxygen rich blood. Here is carbon dioxide rich blood, here is oxygen rich blood. Okay, carbon dioxide rich blood from, that is deoxygenated blood from all body parts is carried by the largest vein, that is called the vena cava, and the blood deoxygenated comes to the right atrium. Clear everybody, right atrium. So what coming to right atrium? Vena cava. From where they are coming? They are coming from carrying the blood from different body parts. Deoxygenated blood from carbon dioxide blood from all body parts come to the right atrium by vena cava. And that blood, okay, now we can see another type of circulation. You can see, and from the right ventricle, when the blood is pumped from the right ventricle, you can see the ventricle, left ventricle. From the left ventricle, the blood is pumped out to the aorta. This aorta carries oxygen rich blood or oxygenated blood to all body parts and supply oxygen to all body parts. That blood from the body parts, rich in carbon dioxide, will come to the right atrium through vena cava. This type of circulation we call systemic circulation. So what is systemic circulation? The blood is coming to the left atrium, left ventricle. From the left ventricle, when the left ventricle beat, the oxygen rich blood will enter the aorta and goes to all body parts. Supply blood oxygen to all body parts. And from all the body parts, the carbon dioxide blood is captured, and by the vena cava, which is the largest vein in our body, will come to the right atrium. This type of circulation, starting from the left ventricle, will flow through all body parts, and from all body parts vinyana carry the deoxygenated blood to the right ventricle. Such a circulation is called a systemic circulation. So pulmonary circulation and systemic circulation happens in single cardiac cycle. In a cardiac cycle, there are two circulation happening, pulmonary circulation and systemic circulation, that constitute one half beat or cardiac cycle. This is called a double circulation. So what is double circulation? Be very clear. Okay? From the left ventricle, the blood goes out through the aorta and supply blood oxygen to all body parts. Carbon dioxide blood from all body parts come back to the right ventricle through vena cava. This type of circulation is called the systemic circulation, pulmonary circulation plus systemic circulation form the double circulation. This is the most efficient method or system of circulation, which increases the oxygen efficiency. Which increase the transport of oxygen efficiency in the cells. So got it? Now, I told you the aorta is the largest artery in our body. The aorta starting into arteries. Aorta divides into arteries. Arteries into still smaller arteriole, and arterioles into very thin blood vessels, capillaries. So you must remember, aorta is the largest artery, aorta divides into still smaller arteries, then arteries divides into still small arteriole, and arteriole divides into very still, very small capillaries. And these capillaries supply blood to the tissues and organs. Okay? Organs or tissues. Organs or tissues. From the tissues and organ, you can see venule. It means capillary rejoin to form venules. Venules become veins. Veins become the largest vein called the vena cava. You got this idea? Now, what is a hepatic water system? There is a special type of vein that we can say the bladder is flowing from the digestive tract or digestive system to the liver. The blood vessels connecting the digestive system, particularly small intestine, large intestine, and you can see stomach aspect. The small intestine, large intestine, and stomach, that are the main regions for the digestive system or digestive. From digestive tract, the blood flows into the liver through hepatic water system. So what is hepatic? Hepatic means liver. The word means hepatic. Portal means carrying to the visceral, that is digestive tract. So this is what is called a double circulation, and all of you watch this video and understand the video. Okay? Thank you.